Higashi here, right here, Gene, and welcome to another Top Countdown episode for GTA 5. Today we've got top 25 most customizable cars, with the 25th spot being the least customizable and the first spot being the most customizable, with the variety and options given. We'll be all put in order from 25th to first, so it's all factual with what you see in this video, and there's an extra spreadsheet in the link in the description below you guys can check out. Thanks to Nismo and Richard Owens, a couple of guys from the crew who took the time out to record some of the footage of also for this episode, as well as getting a massive list down of research given for each of the cars that are customizable in the game. So absolutely insane stuff there, so much appreciate for them for doing that. Of course, you guys can skip to whatever you want in the description below for the times given for each of these car placements. But yeah, like I said, this is all factual. So what you see now, 25th spot, Sentinel XS with 14 customizable parts. Given that, it still looks absolutely amazing stock regardless, as well as fully custom. There's a few things you can change with spoiler, bumper skirts, and many more as well. Just for giving 14 parts, remember. But 24th spot, we've got Sultan with another 14 parts. This is surprising to me because this one actually has a lot of visual change, and that's what I was going to talk about, because I'm going to do a couple of other episodes related to the custom cars. I'm going to do one top 25 again for this, but top 25 cars that are most changed from stock to fully custom. So those might be even with less parts from the list. You see some have 7 options, some have 6, but they completely change from the stock to fully custom version. So that's what I'm going to do, another 25 list for this. But what you're seeing right now, like I said, it's all in order for the least custom to the most customizable with the 25 cars given. And the rest of the list, like I said, is on the spreadsheet. So what you can see here, so many options you can use with the Sultan, man. You can make it look like a rally car for dirt racing, or you can make it look like a street racing car, like as you can see, for example, there. But 23rd spot, we've got Ponte Jukes. 15 parts this time, so we've gone past the 14s, a couple of them beforehand, but now moving up to the 15s now, and this is in Ponte Jukes. Once again, you know, a stock looks completely naked, but once you customize this car, so many things that change with it. And there's quite a bit of options. At first you think it's got a ton of options, but when you actually count them, excluding all the nationality flank, which was given as 1 point, along with another point just for the painted hood, so that's 2 points in total for that. That's why it's 15. And if we were to count every single nationality flag given, of course this would be one of the most customizable cars in the game, but we're not going to do that because that's unfair. But 22nd spot, we have the Piotte. This is interesting. I wasn't actually expecting this to make it into the list, but after researching, of course, these guys found that this has actually 15 customizable parts. I haven't actually really taken the time out from GTA 5 to give these cars a go, to be honest. As you know, I'm constantly racing all the time, but you know, now that I realize, I'm looking back at my car showcase, this actually had quite a bit of customizable options. And given that it's got 15 here, and quite a bit of unique options as well, which not a lot of other cars have, of course, which is expected for the lowrider. But it looks absolutely sexy in the pink with the rear tire sticking out, which is another awesome unique feature. Extra tire, of course, on the rear, sorry, not rear tires. What the hell am I talking about, man? But yeah, another fantastic feature there for that car. Vapid Piotte looks sexy anyway. But 21st spot, we have the Rack Truck, which has 15 parts to change around with. And this is obviously the new sort of an updated version of the Rack Loader that we recently received. And I guess it's, like I said in my car showcase, when I was showcasing this, I don't really enjoy it, but it's still something that you can just use other than the Rack Loader. But then again, what's interesting is that what you find out, that for some reason the Rack Loader has more custom options. But then again, it's understandable because the Rack Truck doesn't require that many changes because it's refurbished, which is you know, makes sense. But it does look nice when you get the color job and the paint job together. As you can see, one example here, and nice and polished off. 20th spot of the Glendale with 16 customizable options. This obviously came with the Hipster DLC update, which, you know, brought quite a few cars with a lot of customizable options. And one thing I do want Rockstar to do, which we keep saying I do, and hope, and I wish they could, but hey, you know, to give more cars in the game more options. You know, some cars deserve a lot more options because it can play around with our creativity with combinations of variety that we can come up with for these cars, instead of limiting us for certain cars that have only about 2-3 parts, but it's one of our favorite cars, you know. So I don't like the way the options are distributed between the cars. It's so random, as you see and go with this list. You know, a lot of the cars don't really have any sort of relations. It's just you know, whatever Rockstar says and provides, and you know, there you go. Just take it. Take it and play around with it, you know, till you get the best combination. But hey, your variety always keeps the game interesting, man. But 19, we've got the Dubs of 6x6 with 17 parts, moving swiftly on 17 now. And this has actually got quite a bit of options, which, you know, is sort of understandable. Once again, a DLC car that came along, one of the recent DLCs. And it's quite nice to play around with off-road, of course, with all the unique combinations you can come up with this one. But generally speaking, it just does look fantastic, regardless, customized or not. But as we know, that's from like sort of the Top Gear episode of Mercedes showcasing that and how sexy it was. And all of a sudden, holy shit, it brought it in. But 18th, once again, another Mercedes. Got a Schwarzer. The better fact, a Schwarzer. This guy does look absolutely sexy. But then when you customize it with 17 parts, oh boy, the combinations you come up with, it's really, really good, man. This, here's the thing about this car is that it's fantastic for racing. It honestly is. When you see people, if you were to only do Schwarzer racing, right, and you can even do this for multi-car racing within sports, because it is one of the slowest sports cars in the category, you can easily organize a multi-class racing. Look how sick this looks, you know, fully tinted out windows with the spoiler given, along with the rims and the front design. This, just generally speaking, the entire car is just absolutely sick, you know, the rear lights, whoa, so good, man. But 17th spot, we have the Quick Classic. It's got 17 parts, similar to the Schwarzer there. And this obviously is one of the most difficult cars to drive in the game. It does become a little bit predictable with the way you have to, you know, turn through the corners, but it's still, you have to be extremely patient with it to really optimize it. So the thing about this car is that it's got a nice design, it's got a nice slick design, but then there's so many bumper options which give you that option to be a little bit more unique. But then again, there's not many other parts, so a lot of the sort of the parts taken up from the 17 total value, the options given mainly from the bumper. But the Zentorno, on the other hand, has 18, coming at the 16th spot, halfway. Well, it's not really halfway, but you know, it's we're approaching that marker now. But 18 spots, you know, sort of expected this had to make it into the list given the options. Of course, there's a bit of a few limitations when it comes to spoilers, but other than that, everything else is expected to be there for the car. Batman, Yakuya man, Yamasi man, a Batman fantasy. She got her skirts on the bumper. I want to give you a taller pump of re. I want to give you a fuck up on the asshole. I want to give you the ripple anal bleed. I want to give you the anal relapse. I want to give the Zentona beast. I want to give you a beast and a pussy. I want to give you everything your mother wants. I want to give your nana a pussy massage. I want to give her all a banana hole. Oh, what the fuck? Yo, alright, so we got obviously equally distributed parts for the Zentorno there. It looks absolutely brilliant. But the Schafter, which is another benefactor, so like the Schwarzer, of course, the brother to that, as well as the Dubster. Quite a bit of Mercedes making it in this list, you know. And the Mercedes must have signed a deal with a contract to say, you know what, if my motherfucking cars go in this game, I want my motherfucking cars to have the extra customizable option over the other car companies and manufacturers. You know why? Because Mercedes, it's the most sexiest car looking game car. Yeah, okay. That's a really bad pitch. Holy shit. Schafter, 18 options. The best sedan in the game to use. Looks absolutely fantastic. Quite a few similar features to the Schwarzer, of course. But it's sick. Definitely got to get this car because there's so many things you can do with the customization. I went for a nice simple look with the racing feel. I don't want to get too distracted with the customizable options given. But hey, 14th spot. Still sticking around the 18, 17 market, but 18 parts, of course, suggest a race car. It's got similar, exactly the same options as the normal version of the car, just to confirm that. We did double check that. So, yeah, 18 parts. First, you know, when you actually use this car for the first time and go into the module, like, whoa, there's so many options, but you wouldn't expect this to only have 18 parts. I say only because, of course, there's 40 or 13 more other cars that's got extra customization options over the Jester and the Jester race car. So, yeah, I mean, it does change quite a bit visually, of course. That's one thing I wanted to say. Of course, you'd see quite a bigger change on the normal version, especially if you were not distracted by the livery here. But you can see quite a bit of nice drastic changes with the spoilers as well. And it gives a nice look to it. Nice, awesome street racing car look, which is, of course, what it's meant for. So, yeah, Jester, you handling beast, traction god. All right, look at this. 13th spot, Sabre Turbo. the stock version right now, you see. But 19 spots. You know, I expected this to be high up in the list. There's not many muscles, though, however, you know, in this particular list, you see, with options. But Sabre Turbo definitely has a lot to play around with. It's a great car. We actually used this for racing one time. You know, muscle car racing with the Sabre Turbo. It's amazing because of its turning circle. You can have multiple Sabre Turbos side by side. Of course, given the understanding of the car and how actually to approach it with other cars around you. But with its turning circle, you don't really need to brake much. You know, you can pretty much floor most of the corners in the game, or just let go of the throttle and let the car slide in and slide out. And you can carry a lot of speed through these corners just because of its turning circle. So you can actually keep up with a lot of other cars. So it's really nice. The risk taking is there with this car. There's not much restriction. And it looks absolutely fantastic when fully customized. And as you can see, one example here. Not my personal color choice, but hey, someone that recorded, like, what, out of Nismo and Richard, they recorded an example here, as well as the Penumbra, which I've got my own favorite version of this car, because this car is fucking sick from its stock version. You would not expect this to have this many options when you first start to use this car. And when you go into the mod shop for the first time, if you refer back to my car showcase with this car, oh lord, I was extremely happy. Like, it was really nice with the options given. Similar feeling that you get with the Felter, but you already can see the Felter's got custom options there default, but this had nothing. It was completely butt naked, polished off, and next thing you know, slap on all these options, 19 options given, you got the Penumbra looking completely different. If you get the stock version and the fully custom version side by side and fully riced it up, you're gonna get some insane comparison, and both of them look alike, of course, the general sort of design. But look at all of these options, man. Look at these spoiler options you can choose from, and this is by far my favorite spoiler, of course, on this car. And not necessarily the color combination, but as you can see, what you can play around with there, it looks sick. Definitely looks sick. But 11th spot, we got the Misacro with 20 options. This is slightly I don't know, surprised me a bit, because I personally don't use this car a lot. But I do remember when I used it for my car showcase, it did have quite a bit of options, but I didn't expect this to have 20 total options. But you can see a couple of roll cage options as well, which is interesting. I didn't know that, you know, I thought it only had one. And then the exhaust only has one as well, which I thought, you know, that's what sort of caught me off guard, because a lot of the times a lot of options do come from the exhaust options. But it's got a nice racing vent as well, which the Felter also has. And you can choose from carbon, of course, which gives that extra option. I'm not a huge fan of carbon on GTA 5 anyway. The carbon options given, I want a lot more color showing than just the carbonated bits. But spoiler, you can definitely see here, a couple of bland options, and then it just becomes a little bit over exaggerated with some huge ass spoilers, which, you know, sort of may have caught you off guard when you first started to customize this. But yeah, nice, awesome bumpers there. You can see in the rear and the front, especially on the front, it's rather unique given the spoiler as well with the Misacro label. But a Futo, of course, making it to top 10 list. Now, of course, you'd expect this to have quite a bit of custom options, but exactly the same as the Misacro with 20 options given. But it does have a lot of visual change, given that, you know, all these options with exhaust bumpers, it's all nicely distributed between each part and not one over the other like the classics. So, you know, the spoiler is another thing with this car. You know, there's quite a few nice personal options you can go for a nice sort of nice race or a rally look. Go with a fat spoiler. This is my personal design. This is the way I've went with it. It's my personal preference, because I don't want too much going on with my car, otherwise I'll get distracted. And so I went with a nice, simple, plain look, and it gives you the most out of it. But of course, the 9th spot, got the Rat Loader with 21 options. But that's expected, people, because look at the pile of shit version of it at stock. But when you customize it, man, you can just choose out of all the options given to make it look nice. But I personally don't see why they brought in the Rat Truck version of this. Maybe they just, I don't know what it is. Maybe a smooth polished paint job would be the only excuse. But because, you know, this one obviously looks a bit rusty, because obviously we know there's two different versions of the Rust, the Rebel itself. But, you know, it's interesting. I feel that they could have given another option with the car, with the DLC, instead of giving a Rat Truck. But hey, I don't know. I'm not the one to decide, but I just must state my opinion here. But, you know, we this game has a potential for a lot of awesome, awesome cars to come in. I can't wait to see the new cars that have already been, you know, confirmed to come out. But yeah, 8th spot here, got the Dubster, the normal version, yet again a benefactor. Holy shit, benefactor's dominating, and you know, the conspiracy still is there on the table to be agreed or disagreed upon with, you know, the manufacturer of Mercedes coming along with rocks. Okay, anyway, you know, 23 options, people. This car, or this Jeep SUV, whatever you want to call it, man, changes a lot visually from the stock to the fully custom version. You can make this look like a sort of a nice, I don't know, a mountain riding Jeep, whatever you want to see. The way I designed it is to make it suited for that, going through the woods, you know, we're getting stuck in a pothole basically. But that's up to you how you see. You can make it into a nicer racing feel as well. It's completely down to you. The options are given there, so much change from. But of course, once again, seventh spot now, we have the Warrener from the Hipster DLC, along with the Glendale. They're giving you a hell of a lot more parts on the Warrener. 24 options, man. But what, yet again, you can give this a nice rally car feel, or you can give it a nice street racing feel. It's up to you. The options are there. Bumpers, everything, you name it, hood, everything is literally there. You know, it's ridiculous. The spoilers are interesting as well. Quite a few unique designs. I'm loving the duct tape in the front, but I decided to go with the closed out headlights there. And I felt comfortable with this look. This is something that just went off scratch. It was, I think, a bit of silver or grey, I'm not sure, with white secondary. But yeah, it's just something that really stood out. The white does really stand out with secondary colour. Or even black, it's up to your mood. But yo, whoa, Elegy. You know, you gotta give the GTR some love, man. This motherfucker, you know, 24 custom parts. It's still a sexy looking car, man. You can't go against that. You know, sixth place. It's with its 24 options, you expected this to be high up there anyway. Don't know if you guys use this, but obviously a free car. I'm sure a lot of you guys do or should have this. And all of these awesome options to make this car look absolutely beastly. You know, definitely a straight street racing car. You can just tell right from scratch. And it's all of this. There's a few combinations I can go for that makes this car look sick. But a lot of the things that make it stand out is the paint job. You know, a bit obvious, but if you put the appropriate paint job for this car, man, it can really stand out with the options given with the customization. But here's the thing, I personally did not like this color here. This was not my footage, but I've got my awesome color combination for this car. I actually did end up selling that car, but I should be able to get it back because it's free, because obviously I'm trying to make space in my garage to test the cars out. Hey, yo, did you guys expect this to be in the fifth spot? The Canis body with 26 custom options. But then again, it is Trevor's personal vehicle, and it is expected for Rockstar to be a little bit biased on that when it comes to characters, main characters, personal vehicles. They tend to have a lot more options, which is what you'll see in the top five anyway. And given the 26 options for this, which is obviously Trevor's personal vehicle, there's so many forms you can come up with the variety of the options given. It's unreal, man. One form can look completely off to another, but it's the exact same vehicle, just the options make it completely different, which is crazy. This is one of the most visually changing cars from stock to fully custom, given your choice. Of course, fourth spot, you can't go away with Coquette. This is absolutely sick when it comes to variation of personal choice. Yo, if every single car had this many options, you know, 27 or more, with all of the detail going into what the Coquette has gone into with Rockstar's design for this car, that would be insane. Just imagine all different, the car showcases and meetups would be much better. You can see detail of people's actual options. It would be extremely fun, you know. But you know, it's unfortunate that this is sort of one of the only sports cars with this many options, along with the whole sort of fastest cars, I guess you could say. Hey, the thing about this car is it's awesome for free roaming, but it's unfortunate in a racing point of view. It's not that great when it competes to the other sports cars in the category. But hey, you can always use it for multi-class racing. But free roaming is awesome. You know, it's awesome high speed turning circles there, swift responsiveness to be able to weave through cars and between little gaps and between two cars side by side, especially traffic lights, awesome. But hey, this is one example of a custom combo, but there's so many different options you can choose from, just from the spoiler as well. So third spot, Franklin's Buffalo, or Buffalo S, whatever you want to call it. 30 custom option, 30. Of course, this is the second characters, you know, we've already seen Trevor's Canis body. Now we've got Franklin's Buffalo. We're only missing, I think, Michael's one, which you'll see. Absolutely crazy. But this Buffalo S, 30 options, once again. It's actually extremely fun car to drive and also to race with. You know, considering its sort of size, you know, you'd expect this to be a muscle car in real life, which it is. But in the game, they put it into the sports category. With that being said, this would be perfect for motocross racing. You know, once again, it's one of the not I guess you could categorize one of the slowest, but one of the quickest out of the slowest, as you could see, you could say. And it certainly is extremely fun to drive. The car does turn. You know, it's got you'd think that it would understeer a lot, but it's got awesome turning circle. I mean, obviously, not generating that much speed, but it still does have that awesome feel to it. Sounds great as well. But second spot, we have the Penty. This is also got 30 options. And this obviously is from, once again, a DLC. And all of these sort of, you could say, hipster designs with so many options given. I literally went for an absolute random look. Because you could choose from a race look to a camping look to a picnic look to whatever, mountain climbing, all sorts. There's so many different forms you can make the Panto into. It's unreal with the variety there. But the first spot, similarly to the tailgater here, which is of course Michael's car with 36 options. Absolutely 36 customizable options with each part. There's so much to choose from. It's unreal, man. Unreal. Look at how many bumper options there are for the front as well as the rear put together. You can spend so much time with this, but it's unfortunate once again that they sort of slapped all these options for Michael's car. I mean, tailgater is a nice car, of course, it's the Audi, but it's not commonly used on multiplayer. I haven't really seen it about as much. You know, people haven't really sort of got this, I guess, and a lot of people don't actually use this for racing as well, but it will be nice as always for you know, racing with other car classes, and this could be one of them. But you know, now that we understand all of the placements between the top 25 most customizable cars, you guys will see the next few episodes with the most change from stock to fully custom, as well as my personal opinion on my personal favorite top 10 customizable cars on GTA 5. So thanks for watching, guys. This is pretty much it for the factual side of things. Hopefully you guys get a perspective now, and it's extremely weird how they've done it. Of course, understandable with the top cars are mostly the main characters' cars, of course, which is expected. But other than that, you know, I just hope when the new cars come out for DLCs, they bring a lot more options, of course, as well as more for the existing ones in the game, which is highly unlikely. But anyway, instead of letting me know what your top 25 would look like, of course, because it's factual and order doesn't really change given the values of options for each one and its placement. But instead, just let me know what your top 10 best custom cars are on GTA 5. I'm curious. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Hopefully you guys found it useful. I'll see you guys next time. Shaggy is signing out. Good night. Peace. Yay! Hey guys, Shaggy here, aka G-Unit. Welcome to my personal favorite top 20 best sounding cars on GTA 5. This is requested by quite a few of you guys, but I will.